Hey Lego fans, it's Jang here from JANGBRiCKS.com with a look at an old Lego system town set. This one was called Trauma Team. It was released in 1992, came with 291 pieces. The vehicles over here have numbers on them, so I'll just go through them by number and then go from there. So number one is a bike, a motorcycle. Old style motorcycle. I like that chassis that's used for these. And this one has clear wheels. That's pretty cool. And I like what they did with the add-ons, at least on the back, you know, bulking it up compared to the way this looks normally without all this stuff added on here. You know, that works out pretty well on the sides. Doesn't really carry anything though, so it's really just gonna be transporting the one person. This front piece though comes off very easily. This is something that, you know, just is gonna be like that. And play value for that is going to be kind of low because that's just always going to fall off. Fortunately, you don't really need the lights here because you still have the light back here. So this one works out pretty decently well. And there's what it looks like with a minifigure on it. You see, he sits right down in there. They got a nice space for him, kind of pinches the legs against that little center flap going through there. Yeah, that looks pretty good. Vehicle number two is the big one. Would you believe this is supposed to be an ambulance? Yes, this is supposed to be a futuristic ambulance. And very odd proportions with this one. It's four studs wide, very boxy and angular, but very long. And it has a lot of overhang back here. It almost looks like it's trying to be a garbage truck back there. Lights on it, siren way back here. Huge cockpit area that just holds the one figure. So that's a little interesting. I like the little console there. That's nice. Angled forward a little bit and your figure will sit deep down in there pretty far. There's what that looks like. Close that down. All right. That's his spot. It's just a huge dome, a huge window to use, and so much overhang in the front. It's a weird design. Thinking back to 1992, I can kind of see this being an appropriate futuristic looking vehicle for the time, but even for that time, it was getting a little bit behind its times because I feel like some concept cars from the late 80s were looking more interesting than this. Good thing is that it does take a full gurney, full stretcher with the wheels that fold. The wheels don't actually turn, but they still look pretty good. It does take that inside, and it's got the windows on the side so that when it's open, you can see your patient on the stretcher there. Just kind of monitor them from the outside because you don't have room to put another figure inside to actually take care of that patient while you're driving around. Looks kind of weird from the back too. Look at that. Just so narrow, and at least this piece right here is good for picking this up. I don't know. So far, this is just, to me, it's just really weird. This though, this takes weird to a whole nother level. This is a single driver car, I think. What? It's the same height as the big old supposed ambulance thing over here. So they match, you know, but it's just, I mean, here, watch. Driver. Mm-hmm. Yep. Steering wheel all up in the face. Well, I can see around. You can see his eyes right there, right? That's safe, right? So this guy is supposed to lean to the sides to see around, and he gets this big, huge vehicle, and all it can do is carry him and his little first aid kit back here. There's a single little stud piece in here, and actually it's a tile, transparent tile. Don't know what that's supposed to be, but it's supposed to be something, you know. It's use your imagination a little bit, represents something related to saving people's lives. It's nice that it does have a little cargo bin back there that you can actually get into, but not sure many kids could really relate to this the way that they could relate to what it's, I don't even know what it's supposed to be, so I don't know how to compare this to anything. Well, it is what it is, so there you go. That is a helicopter. That is very clear, makes sense, and it's a reasonable design. This I'm down with. It has the two gurneys on the sides that are clipped on so you can actually carry two passengers away. You've got little engine details on the side, I'm assuming is what those are supposed to be. An antenna back here, marker light, spinning rotors. Okay, this makes sense. Open up the canopy there. You've got two control sticks. Take another one of the minifigures with the helmets and just get him in the seat. Get his hands lined up with the controls. Bring the canopy down. That looks good. That looks very good. I appreciate this one. And with your gurneys out on the sides, you can put a patient out there. Unfortunately, the patient is going to get completely blasted with the rotor wash, but that's okay. And kids aren't going to worry about that. So this, I think, is a success. The minifigures you can see are not very varied. Most of them having all the same parts. All the heads are the same. The torsos are the same on four of them. And even the helmets are the same on a couple of them. Let's turn one of these around so you can see that there's no print on the back. Of course, back in these days, they only had single-sided heads. And this is your one patient figure over here. Again, no printing on the back of that one, but at least this one is different. So a lot of folks to help out one person, but you know, the general idea is that you would use this with other sets. So you would have all of these folks to act as first responders and EMTs for your entire town. Folks say all the time that old Lego stuff is better than new Lego stuff, and that's just a result of the nostalgia effect. Sometimes I agree with it, but here with this set, I definitely do not. There's also a running complaint that new Lego sets are way more expensive than old ones, but according to BrickSet.com, this set was released at $27.50 in the United States. That's $1,992 for 291 pieces, with four minifigures in here being identical except for one piece each. The play value of this set was pretty good, but the design, I'm not a fan. But those are just my thoughts. Be sure to share your thoughts in the comments section. I'm done for now. I'm going to be moving on to more things, more reviews, as well as custom builds. You can follow everything I do at JANGBRiCKS.com and on this channel. I hope to have a chance to talk to you again soon. Thanks much for watching. Bye for now.